Yo, what's going on, everybody? It is Straight Outta Boston, and today I'm back for episode number 12 of my Los Angeles Rams Connected Franchise Series here on Madden NFL 16. So this week we're taking on the San Francisco 49ers, a team that we lost to earlier in the regular season, in what is looking more and more like a very bad loss for the team. It was on the road, but the 49ers entered this game, I believe they're only 3-5-1, so not a very good football team, and it was pretty disappointing to have to lose to them and drop a game, especially when it really looks like every loss is going to count at this point. We are kind of holding on to our playoff lives right now, not looking so great. But anyway, here is what I'm going to be doing for the game prep from now on. I'm not actually going to be showing them in the videos, but I figure I should tell you guys at the very least. I'm doing these in-game drills because you can only do them with three players as opposed to doing six with the actual, just like the game prepper. You get XP, I don't know what the name is, but you get more XP for your players. So I'm going to be doing those from now on. I'm probably not going to be showing them in many of the videos, but I just kind of wanted to make sure you guys were aware of how I was gaining all my player XP. I'm going to be doing it mainly with the young players. That time I did it with Blake Wells, Amon Moats, and Janoris Jenkins. In the future, I'll probably really focus on it with Blake Wells because I want to get his overall up as soon as possible. So Danny Trevathan is out this week for the LA Rams. He is likely going to be out for the rest of the regular season. Carlos Hyde also out for the 49ers, but take a look at their roster. Not a very good one. Only one player over a 90 overall, and he is an offensive lineman. Just not many good players on this team. Really, we should be able to take advantage of it, but we will see. Of course, we had trouble against this team last time around. They have a pretty good defense. I think that is really what gave us trouble the first time we played these guys, but we're at home this time around, and hopefully we are going to be able to pick up the victory, but we will see how things go. So here we go. Week number 11 from Rams Stadium in Los Angeles, California, or probably Inglewood, California, I guess would be the correct way to put it, or the correct location in the future. But either way, you can see here teams getting ready for the matchup. Take a look at the NFC West standings. So the Rams, after dropping last week, fall to 5-4. We are 0-3 in the division, looking for our first division victory. Now a game back of first place. So this game, I tried out the pistol playbook, which I really did not like after using it this game. I think it probably did us more harm than good trying to use this playbook, but you'll see throughout the game, you know, Wells operating out of the pistol for the most part in this game. I probably won't use it again, but either way, here we go. First and 10, handoff to Gurley up the gut. He breaks a tackle, breaks another one, and is going to roll forward, pick up about 9 right there. Now third and 1 later in the same drive. We're going to go a read option here. Wells takes it himself, takes the hit, holds on, and picks up the first down. Now into field goal territory, 3rd and 4. Wells dropping back. He's going to step up and scramble, but he is stopped short. So we would settle for a field goal there, make it a 3-0 game. And it's Colin Kaepernick trotting out to start the game for the San Francisco 49ers. Brock Osweiler, not injured, who we saw the last time we played these guys, but rather he has been benched. So they're going with Kaepernick this game. We'll see how it goes. It looks like he's played the last couple of weeks. Did not start very well. Willie Hayes got the sack there and forced the 3 and out. But the 49ers defense answers right back. Navarro Bowman picks off Blake Wells right there. That is going to give the Niners very good field position. Ensuing 49er drive. Kaepernick finds his man up the gut right there, up the middle, I should say. Dwayne Bowe making the grab. Now it's a handoff to their halfback, Jonathan Dwyer. Actually, that's Ethan Parks, excuse me. Parks is going to lose a couple yards there. Now later in the drive, 3rd and 10. Kaepernick fires wide to Fred Davis right there. Incomplete. So San Francisco would settle for a field goal of their own. We are not at that at 3. Now here we go. Next drive for the Rams. It's Tavon Austin. Can he get to the corner? Yes, he can. He is loose inside of the 20. 15, 10, 5. Touchdown. 83 yards down the field. Tavon Austin using the speed, getting all the way to the end zone. And the Rams get the first touchdown of the game. We are going to take a 10-3 lead. Take a look at the replay. This was the final man. He had to beat Eric Reed. Could not take the right angle right there and ended up letting Austin get loose all the way for the score. So now next Niner drive to Ethan Parks going to the left side. He's going to pick up about 8. Here we go. Now 1st and 10. Another handoff to Parks up the middle. He breaks a couple tackles and he will pick up another 8 yards right there. 2nd and 2 from the 45. Jonathan Dwyer's turn. Now he gets to the outside, breaks a tackle, and picks up the first down to the 49-yard line. Now 1st and 10 for Kaepernick. He scrambles and he is sacked by Willie Hayes, his 2nd of the game. Now 3rd and 11 coming up. Kaepernick out of the gun, looking, fires left side. It is Dwyer who is going to pick up the first down right there, just barely, but the drive continues for the 49ers. Now it's 3rd and 12. Kaepernick looking over the middle. He's got his man. It's Parks who's going to get the extra yards after the catch and pick up the first down. Now 1st and 10, handoff to Dwyer. Actually, yeah, this is Dwyer. Excuse me. I'm always getting these Niner running backs confused, but it is Dwyer picking up the first down. Later in the drive, now 3rd and 6. Kaepernick scrambles to the right side. What's he going to do? Fires end zone. It's almost intercepted. That will fall incomplete, set up 4th down, and the Niners would settle for a field goal. available. It is 10-6 right now. Wells dropping back. He gets hit. He is going to be brought down, but there is a flag on the play. We'll see who it is on, and they're zooming in on the man who got the sack right there. Let's see if he is the offender, and yes, he is. They're going to call a face mask penalty. So that's going to give the Rams 15 yards and a first down. Now later in the drive, 2nd and 10. Wells feels the pressure again, and it's another sack this time for Ian Williams, who is going to pick up his first sack of the afternoon. We would end up punting it away. Next 49er drive, under 30 seconds to play in this first half. It is Fred Davis up the middle, picking up the first down. Timeout San Francisco. Now Kaepernick out of the gun looking. He's going to scramble up the middle, pick up about 9 yards right there, getting inside of field goal territory, and San Francisco would call their last timeout. Settle for the field goal. It is up and good. So 3 field goals get the Niners to within 1, and that is going to be the score at the end of the first half. You're going to see we've just run out the clock right there. So 10-9 is your score, and we are going to, you can see I skipped the halftime presentation by accident, so this is the screen I'm going to be showing you guys for the halftime stats. But overall, good first half for the Rams, I would say. Our defense has played relatively well. We've let the Niners drive down the field a couple times, but nothing too big, and we've kept them out of the end zone, which is really the big part. So our offense needs to play a little bit better, though. We'll see if we can pick it up in the second half. Here we go, play action fake. It is Soma Good picking up a good chunk right there. So we got the short field here, and this is what I'm talking about. You know, the only touchdown we've scored so far came off the big play, and then here we go. We're driving down the field, but we started off with a short field there after that Kaepernick sack on their first drive made them punt it away from basically their own end zone. Kenny Britt, he's going to make the grab right there, get us to the 1 yard line. Now we're going to go pitch play to Gurley to the outside. He's going to get in. So we take advantage of the short field, but we really have yet to drive all the way down the field on this 49er team. Other than the Tavon Austin play, I mean, I don't know if you really consider that driving all the way down the field. That was 183-yard play where Austin got loose. Here the Niners get lucky, a little fumble, and they actually recover it. One of their offensive linemen falls on it. So that would set a fourth down. We are going to get the ball with a short field once again. Now play action fake on third down over the middle, and a great pass deflection by the DB from the 49ers. So we're going to attempt a 59-yard field goal here. We've got 10-mile-an-hour winds in our favor, but I did not get the full power on this kick, so Zuerlein misses his first kick of the season. It only took 11 weeks, but here we go. Now Niners starting out with a short field of their own, 3rd and 1. That is going to be caught out of bounds. Fourth down coming up. The 49ers are going to punt the ball back to the Rams, but here we go. 2nd and 8. It's Gurley, and he gets stopped in the backfield. You're going to see 10 carries for 3 yards so far for Gurley. The Niner run defense proved to be tough to solve all game long, and then a bad drop right there in third down. Not that that would have picked up the first anyway, but we're going to have to punt it out of our own end zone here. So Hecker is going to punt this one deep. He's got a good leg and the wind in his favor, and check out this punt. It's going to go all the way down to the 5-yard line, and the Niner return is not even going to bother picking it up, so we're going to down it right there. That is a net gain of 93 yards, I believe 92 yards. That's got to be one of the longest punts in NFL history. That was pretty insane. So next 49er drive, that is going to be stopped short on the 3rd and 5 right there. So they would punt it back to us. 1st and 10, Gurley finally getting under the action there, picks up the first down. Now 2nd and 10, another handoff to Gurley. I finally figured out the best run play in this pistol playbook is just the halfback dive up the middle. So Gurley started to get it going a little bit here in the fourth quarter. Jared Cook over the middle makes the grab. Now 1st and 10. That's going to set up 3rd and 10 from the 12. Wells dropping back. He feels the rush and gets hit. He is brought down. So we're settled for the field goal. It's 20-9 now, though. That makes it a 2-possession game. The way our defense has played, that's got to make you feel good as a Rams fan. So here we go. Ensuing 49er possession. They are driving down the field a little bit right here. Over the middle, it's Fred Davis making the play across midfield into Los Angeles territory. Now over the middle, once again, it's Davis left alone. Could have called a face mask right there, but luckily for us, they do not. Now from the 24-yard line, over the middle, it's Ethan Parks out of the backfield making the play. So the Niners now edging towards the end zone right here. Handoff up the middle. Parks breaks a tackle, breaks another one. He's going to pick up about 8. That's going to set the ball down on the 5-yard line. 3rd and 2 coming up. Kaepernick drops back looking. He scrambles, and he is going to be brought down short of the first down marker. A huge play by James Laurinaitis. So San Francisco settles for the field goal. They do not go for it. Despite being all the way down at the 5-yard line, I think I would have gone for it there. Not too many times you're going to get that close to the yard line on this Rams defense. So anyway, there is Jared Cook over the middle there, picking up the first down. Now we're continuing to throw the ball here as our running game just was ineffective all game long. I did not feel confident running out the clock with the run game. So here we go, play action fake. Now Wells, he's going to take it himself. No one really open, but he gets the first down, goes out of bounds. That will stop the clock, but we get the new set of downs. That is what's important. And then Gurley on the dive up the middle, picks up another first down right there, a gain of about 12 all the way to the 41-yard line of San Francisco. Now 3rd and 8 coming up over the middle, and it's intercepted. A huge play by Duke. In a nacho, I can't pronounce that name, but there you go. Big play by him nonetheless. So the 49ers get the ball back. One final chance, 3rd and 14, looking deep, and that is incomplete. So I don't know why they decided to do this, but with 3 timeouts left, the Niners are actually going to punt the ball away here. I know it's 4th and 14 and they have 3 timeouts, but still, now we really only need like 1 first down to ice this game. And Tavon Austin is I took that one out of the end zone just because I am so confident with Tavon Austin. But here we go. First and 17 after a holding call. It's Gurley up the gut right there. Picks up 7. Now 2nd and 9. Another handoff to Gurley. He's going to pick up about 7 more on this one. So 3rd and 2 coming up. A first down would win this ball game. It's Gurley up the gut. He's got the first down. San Francisco calls their last time out, but that would do it. We could run the clock out from there, and the LA Rams pull out the 20-12 victory. So it was not pretty. It was not easy, but the defense came through and really won this game for us. Wells in the offense, not a great game out of them. Really did not, like I said, did not drive the ball down the field at all this game. You know, took advantage of short fields when we had it and took advantage of big plays when we got them from the likes of Tavon Austin. But either way, definitely some things to work on moving forward. You know, we only had, 281 yards of total offense. Not really that great right there. But the defense, like I said, really impressive today. Stepped up when we needed to, came up with the stops when we needed them. So there you go. That is the ball game. We improved to 6-4 on the season. That is a very big win for us after the, you know, trying to get off the recent schneid we've been on. So we will take any win we can get. And you can see Tavon Austin, 2 catches for 90 yards. He had a pretty typical Tavon Austin type of game. That is a stat line we are used to seeing out of him. There is the man who got the interception. Iheanacho? Is that how you pronounce that? Who knows? Either way, take a look at the stat, sack numbers here. Both teams had pretty good pass rushes today. Like I said, it was a defensive-dominated game, a defensively-dominated game, and that really showed through in the stat line. So that is going to do it. Hope you guys did enjoy. Thanks for watching, and I'm out. Peace.